Hello children, welcome back to the EVS class. Today we will start chapter 11, Home Sweet Home. In this chapter, we will learn about different types of houses, special houses, how to decorate it and ways to keep it clean. Our home is our shelter. We live here with our families. It teaches us to love and take care. We share work and our belongings. In this pandemic situation, our home is not less than a protective gear. So let me tell you, why do we need shelter? We need a shelter to protect ourselves from heat, cold, rain, winds, wild animals and thieves. It is very important to have a permanent shelter as it gives us a feeling of well-being. Social bonding. Social bonding is the process of development of a close relationship between people. Family is the smallest unit of society. Group of families makes a society. So living together in a society brings happiness and gives stability to our life. Next topic is types of houses. There are two types of houses. First is temporary or kaccha. Second is permanent or pakka. As we all know how early man lived, he made tree houses or huts with sticks, leaves, straw, etc. But these huts were not very strong. Such type of huts are found in villages today. They are called as the temporary or kaccha house because they can get damaged very easily. As human evolved, he learned to make strong houses using bricks, cement, wood or iron. These houses are called permanent as they cannot be damaged easily. People living in cities may have many types of shelters such as villas, bungalows and multi-storied apartments. Skyscrapers are very common in big cities. These are very high tower-like buildings that has over 40 floors which seem to touch the sky. These are used for residential purposes to accommodate the increasing population. Next topic is special houses. Special houses are built in different regions depending on the climate or the situation. So first is stilt house. Stilt houses are built on raised wooden poles or stilts. Such shelters protect people from rains and flood. In case of flood, the water might get inside the house if the homes are built on the ground level. So in order to avoid this, houses are built on stilts. They also have sloping roofs so that rainwater can slide down easily. We can see these kind of houses in Assam. Second is tent. A tent is made up of canvas. It can be fixed and folded easily. We can take it anywhere, so it is as movable and portable shelter. It is mostly used during camping. Third is igloo. An igloo is a dome-shaped house made of ice. These type of houses are found in very cold places at the poles like Greenland. These people are called Eskimos or Inuits. Next is caravan. It is a mobile house that has wheels or they can be towed by a car or animals. They are very comfortable. Last special house is houseboat. It is a floating house. It is a shelter made on a boat. They are found in Dal Lake in Kashmir and in the backwaters of Kerala. Next topic is housekeeping rules. In this, I will tell you some points to maintain cleanliness in the house. A house should have enough doors and windows to get sufficient amount of air and sunlight as it helps to keep the insects and germs away. The floor of the house should be swept and mopped with vinyl. Cobwebs should be removed at regular intervals. Flies and cockroaches sit on food, so the kitchen should be kept clean. Garbage should be cleared and collected in a covered bins.
we should use two types of bins. First, for biodegradable waste. Bio means living organism. Degradable means decompose. That means living organism that can decompose waste like vegetable peels and leftover food should be converted into manure. And second, for non-biodegradable waste, which cannot be decomposed by the living organisms, like polythene bags, tin cans and glass bottles, which should be sent for recycling. Insects breed in dark and moist places, so bathroom should be kept clean. Mosquitoes lay eggs in drains and dirty pools of water, so they should be covered. Things in the houses should be kept in their proper places, as it will be easy to find them. Last topic is decorating the house. Everyone likes a clean and beautiful house. We can use many things like matching curtains, furniture, wall paintings, showpieces, flower pots, etc. Many people make colorful designs called rangoli with colors. It is usually seen at the time of festivals. Some people make rangoli with chalk powder, flour, rice paste, colors or petals of flowers. The petal of flowers is called floral rangoli. Floating diyas are used in water rangoli. Rangoli signify happiness and prosperity. In Bengal, flower art is called alpana. In Tamil Nadu, it is called kolam. And in North India, it is known as chokpurna. So these were the different ways by which we can decorate our house. But do you know, there are many people who do not have a house to live in. They take night shelters built on the roadsides, and that is very difficult to live. Can we live like them? Give it a thought. So this was the chapter 11. I hope you all have understood this chapter very well. See you soon. Thank you.